I am Ilya Nasov. I am professor for solar energy. I am working in a lot of projects, especially in solar energy. I am coming from Macedonia, North Macedonia, and I am coming from two companies. I am director of Center for Plasma Technologies, Research and Development Center, and producer of solar thermal collectors, Camel Solar. So all together, that two companies is working research, development, innovation, and plus production. So our products every time have some innovation and some benefits in the area of solar energy. Last 6 years, we started with PVT hybrid thermal collector. What is this? A device which produces electricity from photovoltaics, and backside PVT absorber which produces thermal energy. In total, this device is producing nearly 3 to 4 times more energy compared with photovoltaic. Why? Because photovoltaics is producing around 20-23% electricity from all solar radiation, and our PVT, because it's producing thermal energy, is producing now around 3 times more total energy. So PVT is producing in the moment electricity plus thermal energy. If we analyze PV, we can see that maximum 2023 commercial product of PV has possibility to produce electricity. But how PV is producing electricity? The temperature of PV cells is increasing. In regions as Macedonia, from where I am coming from, Macedonia, and that region during the summer, temperature of PV cells is around 75-80 degrees. How the temperature is increasing, efficiency drastically decreasing, and in that temperature, efficiency is lower more than 20-25%. That heat we are using for heating absorber backside of PV. That absorbed energy, we are transforming to useful energy, and we are transforming and translate to boilers, to tanks, where we are using as sanitary water, for space heating, water for industrial heating, and a lot of the other application. But one additional a benefit of PVT is that the temperature of photovoltaic cells we are controlling in maybe 50 degrees. In 50 degrees, electricity production of PV module is maybe 10% more compared with production of electricity on 80 degrees. So one benefit, 10% or 5% more electricity, and nearly 3 times more heat from the same square meter. In European Union directives, regulation, every time are speaking CO2 emission per kilowatt hour production. In this case, total produced energy is around 3 to 4 times more compared with only PV. It means that efficiency of that device is very high, and plus CO2 emission is lower if we are comparing with kilowatt hour produced energy, in total energy. We started 5-6 years ago. After that, I was a member of International Energy Agency for PVT, PVT Task 60. And really, it was very good option to see all producers and to see where is future of solar energy and future of renewable energy sources. And in that moment we see with that the future will be in PVT assisted renewable energy sources. S, PVT assisted heat pump or PVT assisted gas boilers or PVT assisted hydrogen or the other renewable energy sources. PVT is one device from the same surface as PV is producing three times more total energy. Where is possible to be application of this PVT device? In nearly every producer or every consumer of electricity and heat, nearly everywhere. In residential, in multi-family buildings, in sports center, swimming pools, hotels, hospitals, garden, the children garden, industrial application, solar district heating. We were visited here in Poland, one of the biggest district renewable energy sources district heating, Veolia, where they are using our PVTs, and really it was fantastic to see that solar district heating or solar renewable energy district heating. I told you that nearly zero energy building will be obviously in European Union and nearly in all the world. Every house has needs for electricity and heat, and heating and cooling. 40% from all energy in the world are using 50% of all energy are used for heating and cooling. From that total energy, the biggest part of that energy is heating. So, if you are install only PV, you will solve problem with electricity, but we will not solve problem with heating and cooling. So, in residential, your question, in residential houses or multi-family houses, it is very good to use instead PV, to use PVT, and thermal part will heat water and will go to boilers and tanks. And that, after that, in combination with heat pump and in combination with gas boilers, will be preheated water will be finally heated with these devices. But instead heat pump to use electricity only for compressor, we are producing also heat. So CO2 emission of heat pump will be lower. CO2 emission from gas boilers will be also lower because one part of the hot water will be heated from the PVT. It means that in future, application of PVT will be higher and higher because this is new technology, but the last several years application is increasing several times compared with last several years, 21% per year is increasing application of PVT. So really this is very good option for residential and for all the other users of energy.